Praised be Jesus Christ, laudetur Jesus Christus. Welcome to this live broadcast from St. Peter's Square here in the Vatican, where Pope Francis is about to lead the faithful in the recitation of the Angelus, non-Angelus prayer. I am John Baptist Tumusime. On behalf of Vatican Media, I would like to welcome all of you who are joining us today from the various Vatican News channels. A warm welcome to viewers on Catholic Television, EWTN Television, Shalom World Television, and the listeners who are following us on many radio stations around the world, as well as those joining us through the internet. Today is the 23rd Sunday in Ordinary Time. This Sunday's Gospel passage is taken from Mark chapter 7, verses 31 to 37. Its main theme is Jesus proclaims the kingdom of God through the miracle of healing. Before he leads the faithful in the recitation of the Angelus, Pope Francis will make a brief reflection on today's liturgy. Many pilgrims have gathered here in St. Peter's Square for the Angelus. The temperatures are relatively moderate. The thermometer is reading 28 degrees centigrades. Well, as I have said, there are many pilgrims who are in St. Peter's Square for this Angelus. The Pope is about to appear in the window above St. Peter's Square, where he usually leads the faithful in the recitation of the Angelus. So now I take you back to St. Peter's to hear what is going on there. Again, we are still waiting for the Pope, who is about to appear. I can see that the window is gradually opening. And the people are very eager to welcome him. And so you can hear from the square, they are saying, Viva il Papa, Viva il Papa, long live the Pope, long live the Pope. Of course, the window below is covered with a red curtain, and here, so the curtain is now opening. Here is Pope Francis in the window above St. Peter's Square. The faithful in the square are welcoming him with a loud applause, so you can...
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno.
Dear brothers and sisters, good afternoon. This Sunday's Gospel refers to the episode of the miraculous healing of a deaf mute person by Jesus. They brought him, a deaf and dumb person, begging him to impose his hand on him. Instead, he makes several gestures on him. He led him away from the crowd. On this occasion, like in his other occasions, Jesus always acts discreetly. He does not want to impress people. He is not looking for popularity or success, but he only wants to do good to people. With this attitude, he teaches us that good should be done without clamor and without display. The good should be carried out in silence. When he was away from the crowd, Jesus put his fingers in the ears of the deaf and dumb, and with his saliva touched his tongue. This gesture refers to the incarnation. The Son of God is a man fully inserted into human reality. Therefore, he can understand the painful condition of another person and intervenes with a gesture in which all his humanity is involved. At the same time, Jesus wants to make it clear that the miracle happens because of his union with the Father. For this reason, he looks up to heaven. Then he sighed and he pronounced the decisive word, Ephphatha, which means open. And immediately, the man was healed. His ears were opened, his tongue melted. Healing was for him an openness to others and to the world. This story from the Gospel underlines the need for a double healing. First of all, the healing from illness and physical suffering to restore the health of the body, even if this finality is not completely attainable in the earthly horizon, despite the efforts of science and medicine. But there is a second healing, perhaps a more difficult one, and it is the healing of fear, our fear, that pushes us to marginalize the sick, to marginalize the suffering, to marginalize the disabled. There are many ways to marginalize, even with pity or with the removal of the problem. One remains deaf and dumb when faced with the pains of people marked by illness, anguish, and difficulty. Too often, the sick and the suffering are considered a problem, when actually they should be an opportunity to express the concern and the solidarity of a society towards the weakest. Jesus has revealed to us the secret of a miracle that we can repeat ourselves, becoming protagonists of the Ephphatha of the word open, which has restored the world and meaning to the deaf and mute. It is a question of opening ourselves to the needs of our suffering and needy brothers, avoiding selfishness and the closing of our hearts. It is precisely the heart, that is, the deep core of the person, that Jesus came to open, to free, to enable us to live fully the relationship with God and with others. He became man because man, made interior deaf and dumb by sin, can hear the voice of God, the voice of love that speaks to his heart, and thus learn to speak in turn the language of love, translating it into gestures of generosity and self-giving. May Mary, the Mother of God, who is totally open to the love of the Lord, help us to experience every day in faith the miracle of Ephphatha, to live in communion with God and with our brothers and sisters.
Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini.
Fiat mihi secundum verbum tuum.
Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Verbum caro factum est.
Et habitavit in nobis.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Jesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre. Amen.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Genitrix.
Utini efficiamur promissionibus Christi.
Gratiam tuam quesum, Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, ut qui angelo nunciante Christi fili tui incarnationem coniovimus, per passionem eius ad crucem, a resurrección y gloria en perducamur, pereunda en Cristo, un Dominum nostrum.
Amén.
Gloria a Patria, et Filio, et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amén.
Gloria a Patria, et Filio, et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amén.
Gloria a Patria, et Filio, et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio, et nunc et semper, et in saecula saeculorum. Amén.
Pro fidelibus defuntis, Requiem aeternam dona eis Domine.
Et lux perpetua luceat eis.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Ex hoc nunque nosque in saeculum.
Aiutorium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui fece caelum et terram.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay, the Angelus is over. The crowd has bursting in an applause. The Pope. The Pope is blessing everybody in the crowd. Dear brothers and sisters, yesterday at Loreto, in the Pontifical Sanctuary of Santa Casa, was celebrated the Feast of the Nativity of Mary in Prophecy of the Family. The house of Mary is the house of every family. Let us dedicate this to all the families. Today, in Strasbourg, we celebrate the beatification of Alphonse Maria Epinal, the foundress of the Sisters of the Savior. She was courageous and wise. She prayed, and she was a witness to the gospel of Christ. She helped the sick, she also, who were sick, physically sick, and those who are spiritually sick. So, an applause.
Saluto con affetto tutti voi.
I would like to greet all of you who have gathered here for this Angelus, those who come from the different parts of the world, the families, groups from different parishes and associations. I greet the faithful from the Diocese of Como in Italy, youth who are participating in a conference of the works of the Church, those who are preparing for confirmation from Prevale. I wish everybody a nice Sunday. Please don't forget to pray for me. Good lunch and goodbye. So the Pope continues to bless the people and also to wave to them as. So as you have heard, there is an outburst of long live the Pope, long live the Pope in St. Peter's Square. The Pope has now gone away. Now, this brings us to the end of this live coverage of the Angelus from St. Peter's Square. Thank you for joining us. In a little while, a summary of the Pope's Angelus reflection will be available in the Vatican News web portal. That is www.vaticannews.va. That is www.vaticannews.va. Once again, I am John Baptist Tumusime. Praised be Jesus Christ. Laudetur Jesus Christus.